like these. I always like fresh flowers around the house.
My wife liked them too, especially roses. I always promised myself that if ever I settled anywhere for long enough, I'd plant some for her. She's been gone about 18 years now. I moved away just after she died. We loved this village, but it was never the same without her. When did she die?
New Year.
Yeah, I know it seems hard to believe now, but you'll get over it somehow. We all do.
Hey, kid. What are you up to?
Well, it's maths, homework, probability.
Probably. Hey, right, hey. No, answer me this, then. If an horse hasn't won in the last 10 outings and it finally gets a decent jockey, right, and it likes every going, what then is the probability?
I'm trying to concentrate.
Leave the kid alone, Zach. She's trying to do her homework.
No, but it's a 25-to-1 shot. And if maths could tell us that what the chances are of it winning, well, that's next week's housekeeping taken care of.
Yeah, and if this maths ain't done, that's detention.
Oh,
just looking at the rumpum that creature makes me mouth water. Come on, think of all them rashes.
Well, you can forget it, because you're not killing any of my pigs.
What's the sense on being on half rations when we can live like kings?
No!
Will you two shut up? Debbie's trying to do her homework here.
I'm entitled to my opinion because of my noble gesture. I could be going to prison for you two. Now, whatever happened to the condemned man's hearty breakfast?
Right, that's it. Thank you, Bob.
Just had another warning from the council about late pickups. That makes four.
It's not our fault the truck's being sabotaged, is it?
Maybe not, but we can't afford to be complacent.
I don't think Zach's going to trample another trick like that, do you?
I've told you, it might not be down to them.
Well, who else?
If I knew that, I would call the police. I can't see Zach keeping up this long. Call of vengeance might be strong, but the call of the war pack always beats it in the end. And there's no point asking Councillor Ledbetter what's going on with the contract because he never gives a straight answer. I know that Chris had some good contacts.
I'm still sure it's Zach.
Yeah, whatever, just get it sorted. Ah, hello, this is Zoe Tate, Christopher Tate's sister.
Serve yourself here, is it? Guests do all the chores.
Oh, I'm not really that kind of a guest. No, I'm a friend of the proprietor's daughter.
Oh, I don't give him the right to take advantage of you, though, does it?
Oh, he's a perfect gentleman. I just like to help out when I can.
I'm sorry to have kept you.
Alan Turner?
Tom King?
You two know each other.
From years back. I'd never have recognised him from your description, though.
Well, what have you been saying about me?
Look, you were the perfect gentleman. I remember you as the iron fist of the NY Estates. Hard-drinking, womanising gambler, and those were his good points.
I think you may be exaggerating a little.
Don't you believe it. He could strike terror into the heart of a tenant farmer with a twitch of his eyebrow.
Well, I'm sure we both mellowed a bit since then.
Don't count on it.
Mr. King's booked a room.
Ah. Now, how long will you be staying?
I'm not sure yet. I'm house hunting.
How's it going?
Not too well.
Well, let's have a look. I used to be good at math. The chance that an event happens can be expressed as number of favourable events over total number of events. Thus, the chance of any number being thrown on a dice is 1 over 6, and the chance of an odd number is 3 over 6.
Yeah, I know all that. What are the chances of getting a 3 or 5?
What's the chance of getting some service?
I'm not sure they should be encouraging you to play with dice, Debbie. I've got customers waiting.
If Emily's got the shop and the cafe to look after, they obviously need more staff.
I don't want to work for family. It'll feel like charity. I want to get out and get my own job.
I wasn't thinking of you working here. I meant me. It'd just be nice to have a bit of extra money coming in whilst you're looking for something.
I'll give it a chance. I'll get a job this week.
Well, I hope so. But in the meantime, we have got a few bills piling up, you know.
Yeah? And nothing would give me greater pleasure than paying them out my first week's wages. Trust me, our luck's gonna change. I feel ready for anything.
Yeah, well, if you say so. In the meantime, TJ needs changing. I'll see you later.
Hello, darling. Hello, Jean. How's my little girl?
What do you think you're doing?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to frighten you.
Yeah, I was just having a look around.
Will you take Jean inside? I'm afraid to say we don't give guided tours of the house and gardens, which means you're trespassing.
My mistake. Is that your daughter?
That's none of your business.
True. I'm glad to see you named her after your mother, though.
How do you know that?
Your father and I worked together once, just after my wife died.
I see. Well, I'm sorry I shouted at you, but we've been having problems with vandalism. I have to be careful of strangers.
That's quite understandable. It's my fault I should have phoned first. I just wanted to see the place again. Oh, Tom King.
Emily said you were having trouble with your maths. Well, it's quite simple, really. If the chance of any number being thrown is 1 over 6, then the chance of a 3 or a 5 being thrown was 2 over 6.
Thanks. Do you think you could check the rest for me? I don't really want to get in any more trouble at school.
Seeing as you're not needed for the maths, you can come shopping with me.
I'm not sure Mrs. Hope would be very pleased.
Oh, come on, Em, it'll be a laugh. I'm planning a surprise for Simon.
What sort of a surprise?
Well, don't worry, it's not a leap year proposal. But I do think it's time I started moulding him.
I'm glad you're feeling more positive, but these things take time.
It's been 4 months now. I mean, that's long enough for anybody to be sat in the backside. I feel ready to get out in the world again.
Well, you're certainly ready to make a start.
I could do with a bit of encouragement here. I mean, even Don thinks I'm going to drop TJ every time I give him a cuddle.
Well, young mothers are always overprotective. We're all waiting for you, really, you know.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. Hey, Viv lent me the job ads out of the courier. There's all sorts in here. Pizza delivery, debt collector. Then maybe I could combine the two. Deliver you a margarita, and if you don't pay for it, give you a smack in the nose.
Still got your sense of humour, I say.
Yeah, that's about all I got. Bah, I'm not going to let this beat me. I'm going to get a job. Start providing. Get a bit of pride back in my life.
Don't come any further.
What's the problem?
There's CCTV.
Relax, everything's going fine.
You're not the one at the sharp end if things go wrong.
Nothing's going to go wrong, we're nearly there.
Zoe's having doubts about who's doing all this.
Well, you'll just have to make sure you're the model employee. Kind of bloke she can rely on.
I've always loved this place. Have you had it valued recently?
You trying to make me an offer?
Yeah. I'd even pay a shade over the odds. I don't want to waste time haggling.
Is this how you usually do business?
Cards on the table, it's only fair. Is there much land comes with it?
None.
Ah, you'd want a separate agreement for that, then?
I don't want any sort of agreement. It's not for sale.
You haven't heard me offer yet.
I don't need to.
I assure you I can put my money where my mouth is.
Mr. King, this is my home, and I'm not going to sell it to you or anyone else at any price.
Well, that's clear enough.
Well, I like to put my cards on the table too. But maybe it's not a wasted journey. We have other properties that might interest you.
It wouldn't be the same.
You've still got to live somewhere. And I think you might quite like Holgate Farm. Be worth renting while you look for another dream house.
Only if you promise to show me round. I don't trust agents.
Very wise. Shall we say tomorrow? 2:30?
I'll see you there.
You're gonna regret this, sunshine. Hang on! It's me!
You idiot! What the hell do you think you're playing at?
Trying to make you look like a hero. You ought to be grateful.
Grateful? You could have broken me nose, man.
I had to make it look good. Once the boss sees the security footage, she'll trust you with her life. Wipe that mess off.
Well, it's not too much damage. Just a couple of tyres slashed.
Could have been worse if you hadn't stopped him.
I'm sorry I didn't manage to catch him.
No, you did your best. What worries me is that he was confident enough to do this in broad daylight.
Yeah, well, that's typical Zack, isn't it? He thinks he can get away with anything.
Why are you so obsessed with it being Zack? You can't identify anyone from that. Did you recognise him?
Not exactly. He got away. It certainly could have been Zack.
We know it was Zack.
I suggest we leave the detection to the police. Get on to them.
Ready to go?
I am, but you're not.
Eh?
Got a couple of presents for you first.
Ooh, it's not even my birthday.
I don't need an excuse to treat you.
Does that make me a kept man? Your toy boy? I hear a lot of women executives like to run one. Should I give up work? Just, like, hang around the house all day?
Just open the bag.
Oh! It's quite bright.
Well, that's the style, it's trendy.
And here's me thinking you'd been to a charity shop. Oh, hold on. There's something else in here. Or maybe a jumble sale.
Just put them on.
I get it. We're gonna be hippies, like at Woodstock. Dance naked at Joni Mitchell and make love, not war.
Don't get carried away, it's just a fashion statement.
Doesn't stop the free love, though, does it?
Well, later, maybe. First, I want to see you in them.
Not really me.
Oh, go on. Having a new image can be fun.
Well, it depends on what it is.
Just give it a try.
All right. If I get swamped by new vile women on the way to the Woolpack, well, you'll only have yourself to blame.
I'll risk it. What is it with you lot? Have you got any other people to hassle?
We'd like to speak to Zack Dingle.
What, again?
Yeah. We believe he may be able to help us with our inquiries.
Yeah, and last time he did that, you lot arrested him. Look, he's not here anyway.
Right, well, have you seen him today?
Of course I have. He had egg and sausage for breakfast, but it's not a criminal offence, is it?
What time did he leave?
How would I know? I left the house early, and when I got back, it was empty.
Have you any ideas where we might find him?
Well, you're supposed to be the detectives, not me.
Looks to me like it's either the betting shop or the pub.
Gotta be you around this time, Shadrach. I thought I was excused because of my noble gesture. I'll give you a noble gesture in a minute if you don't get your hand in your pocket, you tight get.
It's all right, Dad, I'll get him in.
Don't bother, Sam. Hmm? I think we've all had quite enough for one day.
We're doing this for you.
How'd you work that out?
Huh? Well, you said, that Debbie wanted some peace and quiet to get on with their homework. Well, the longer we stop in here, the more time she has.
Hey. Now, I don't want you getting too excited, Diane.
Yeah?
It's my new image. Supposed to make women insane with passion.
I think I can just about contain myself.
Wait till you see the shirt.
Oh!
But don't you like it?
Perhaps it takes a bit of getting used to.
Don't worry, Nicola. We innovators have to get used to the odd moment of ridicule. It'll make all the difference once I've added the accessories.
What would they be?
A baggy shorts and a skateboard.
Oh, hey, oh, PC Plod's back.
Can I have a word, Zack?
Oh. Hello, love.
What kept you so long?
Oh, talking to Siobhan. And Viv lent me the papers for the job ads.
Yeah, well, can you get the table laid? I was hoping to get lunch out of the way before TJ wakes up again.
Yeah, there weren't many jobs in it. I did phone for one. Bingo caller in a club in Skipdale.
You a bingo caller?
Yeah, I could do that. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Terry Woods, your host for this evening. A song, a smile, a cardiac arrest. Don't clap too loud, it's a very old building.
Do you really think you could do that then?
Yeah. Well, they did say the position were filled. Promise to keep my name in file in case it came up again.
Well, I'd want you working in a club anyway. Too much temptation.
Oh, yeah. Well, do you reckon all them housewives would be throwing themselves at a sex bomb like me?
You should be so lucky. I was more worried that clubs usually mean smoking and drinking, which is just what you need to avoid.
Yeah. Well, I see my dinner comes with a government health warning these days.
Oh, look, I'm not nagging. I'm just trying to help you get better.
Why do you keep picking on my Zach, Denzil?
Because someone has been slashing ties at the haulage yard again.
Good news there, lads.
See, he's practically admitting it.
Do you mind telling me where you were at 11:20 this morning, Mr. Dingle?
Yeah, I was here in this delightful hostelry supping the finest of ale.
Do you have any witnesses?
Oh, he certainly has. I was with him the whole time.
Yeah, me not.
Me too.
They're bound to say that. They're family. They're going to say anything to keep him out of trouble.
But I wouldn't. And I can tell you, they all came in when I opened the doors this morning and they've been sitting here drinking ever since.
Is it not possible that Mr. Dingle might have slipped out for, say, half an hour or so without you noticing?
Let me explain something to you, officer. You can't help noticing, Zach. Some women came in from the WI about 11. They saw Zach and they left.
Well, it wasn't causing any trouble. Some people like Zach's singing.
But some don't. I have to balance what you lot spend in here against what I lose from other customers.
So the bottom line is, he was here all morning.
I'd swear it.
I still think he did it.
That man has got a cast iron alibi.
See me off, Scott.
Look, I know it's hard, but think of TJ. He needs his dad. What to try and give up for him?
I am trying. But I just get myself in a state worrying about it all. And smoking stops me getting too stressed.
Well, there are other ways.
Yeah, and you don't approve of drinking either. Look, I've always been this way. It's hard to change.
I'm not trying to change you, but it's hard for me too.
Yeah, but we can get through this together.
You're not really going to get a baggy shorts and a skateboard, are you?
Well, that's just the start. By the time I'm finished, I'll be so trendy, you'll be really proud of us.
You're winding me up, aren't you?
You deserve it. Maybe you can take me like I am in the future.
Right. It's the way you like your best.
They're laughing at us.
They can afford to.
Yeah, because they got away with it.
I guess they must have hired some muscle this time.
Oh, I don't know. That's not Zach's style. I don't know, maybe he's always right. Maybe we have to face the fact that it's someone else behind all of this. She's not going to like it when I tell her.
How's the house hunting?
Zoe Tate is showing me around the property tomorrow. Holgate Farm.
Oh, it's a nice house.
No, it's not exactly what I want. But I'm a patient man. It might just do till the right property becomes available.
Well, can I get you a drink?
That's an excellent idea.
Someone has been planning this very carefully. I should have seen it from the start. But you told me everything was under control. I should never have listened to you.
Are you saying this is my fault?
It's my company, so it's my responsibility. But we would never have been caught out like this in the old days.
What's that supposed to mean?
I let you convince me that it was some petty family feud. I lost sight of the bigger picture. Use your brain, Scott, if you've got one. The refuse company is up for renewal, and by a strange coincidence, Tate Trash suddenly encountered some unfortunate problems.
Someone's trying to put us out of business.
Penny finally drops.
You did get arrested then.
Oh, yeah. My innocence shone out like a beacon in the night.
Diane gave him a good alibi, because he'd been in the pub drinking since it opened.
Right. Yeah, and got well drunk by the look of them two.
Hey, where's your gratitude, child? I did this for you. So you could have the house free to do your own work.
Well, thanks, but I managed to make arrangements elsewhere.
Oh, well done, love. Means you'll be able to visit your mum tomorrow.
Oh, great.
And you can get sobered up and all.
Yes, later, woman. There's something we have to do first. A toast.
That's us.
Who's you? Hmm? To that man who braved the Tate lackeys to slash them tyres.
Ah, but we don't know who he is.
Hmm? Well, that's never stopped him building monuments to the unknown soldier, has it? Huh? All right, henceforth he will be known as the Dingle What Has No Name.
The Dingle What Has no name.
Mm. Oh.
We have to start fighting back.
It would help if we knew who we were fighting.
The bids are in for the contracts. They're going to have to show their hands soon. I'll keep ringing around my contacts, see if anyone's heard anything.
Even if Zack does have an alibi, he'll still nose behind it.
Will you forget the Dingles? We're dealing with someone much bigger. Probably thought the company was vulnerable with Chris gone. Especially since I entrusted it to a clown like you. But it's time they realise that I am still a Tate. And we don't roll over for anyone. If they want to fight, they're going to have one. Thank you.